back again, and this time for this video I am going to be engraving a leaping salmon. I've got the salmon leaping over the top. I've just sketched it on with a thin permanent pen and the lettering underneath there, and I've put a few little droplets. But of course working dry on a lovely crystal is worthwhile. Well, that was then. You want to see it now. I shall show you. Non-existent leaves.
Hi everyone. Well, as promised, let's get on with the bamboo subject, which has been asked for quite a while ago. And so, as I showed you in the last video, here I have got a rather large bowl, and I have very roughly sketched on my random bamboo not a botanical study.
It's the same as when we're doing butterfly wings or dragonfly wings. They're only very, very fine, so you don't want to go deep. Otherwise, they look like they're made out of plasticine. Clearly this leaf I'm working on now needs to have that tip sharpened. It looks a bit lumpy, so I will actually be doing that later on when I go over all the leaves. Just making sure they've got nice sharp points. It's not crystalline yet. Look how it's glowing. It's really, really nice. I'm about to start the hand engraving of a whiskey glass. Emotional, I think. I know when I was looking up pictures, I kind of put myself right into the scene with those young lads, and I just felt myself welling up. I had to get out of there fast. It was just too tragic for words. And so, because it's quite special. Gosh, I just don't really know how I'm tackling this. we just gotta play it by ear. Yeah, I mean, if I'm not happy with one way of doing it, I will be able to sort of manipulate the shadings and turn it about. And if it is a complete disaster, I will get another glass and I will start again.
Not going deep, this is a surface engraving.
Hello everybody, welcome to my next creation. They look like looks a bit glary, but in actual fact I will it's just his eyeballs popping out for the moment before I put his eyelids on. Okay, so using this little white or canvas, I'm just going to add a hint of ground. I don't want too much, so I'm just adding a few bits and pieces here. Remember, he's stood on the grass, so some of it is flat. Right, so there you are, Mr. Giraffe, with a little bit of writing on the bottom. Well, that's nice of you to show everybody, Lesley. That's the little white Arkansas. You can see I'm taking it along the stem. That instantly reduces the stem to a half tone, as it's doing with all the diamond. It's such an easy move. It's such a fantastic little bow. Here we have the nice soft grey rubber, which I'm using just in my hands. Well, in one hand, obviously, not two. Right, we've got a little diamond burr, which I am using dry, and it's quite a sharp one, which is nice. And you can see where I'm just putting little sharp effects in the middle there, little highlights. But I'm sharpening the top of the rubber so I can really get into those little antenna. I'm calling them that. I don't know what they are really called. Feelers, I don't know. I've done that many bees before, I should know by now. 2020, that year. We're going to look back at this year and go, oh my goodness. It's a lovely effect having a bee flying around the glass. I have roughly sketched a cat. Oops, I hope you can see that. So, still finishing off with the diamond. Tiny little adjustments here and there. Now we have the little brown rubber. Done a little bit of work behind the scenes, and I have now got three pretty little dragonflies